Hey there, I am Brandi from BrandiStamps.com. I'm here today to show you a special set of four projects all made with the Playful Ghosts stamp set from Stampin Up. This is from my card club, September 2024. And those who are in my club and ordered the optional add-on Halloween treats kit can use this video to follow along and make all of the projects that I've sent to you. But if you aren't in my card club or haven't heard of it yet, this is a great time for you to see what kinds of projects that I offer. Feel free to watch and copy any of the projects you see. And if you want some more information about how to join my monthly Brandi Stamps Card Club, please check out the link that is right in my description where you can learn all the details. I'm always taking new members. So let's get started, guys. So the people who are in my Brandi Stamps Card Club and ordered the extra optional add-on kit from September 2024. It was called Halloween Treats. They paid $25 and they received this stamp set, which is worth $20 on its own, so that's a great value. And then they received all of the things to make our projects. So we've got some treats that we're gonna be using. We've got kind of a big paper that didn't fit in the card kits. And then we've got our four little project kits. So here's treat number one, treat number two, treat number three, and treat number four. So we're going to make all four of the projects here today. So this is everything that I sent to you for $25. Still can't believe what a great value that is. That's why I had so many people participate. There are lots of you out there and I'm very grateful. Thank you for your loyalty and support of our card club. Now, here are a few other supplies you're going to want to have on hand. I sent you the stamp set, but you are going to need to get your blocks out, and we're going to use every single one of the stamps in the set. So I just mounted all of mine and have them ready to go. The only ink pad we're going to use is the Memento Tuxedo Black ink pad, so pull that out. And then I am using a whole slew of Stampin' Blends. Look at all of this. Keep in mind, you could do all of your coloring with any of the blends or other markers or colored pencils or even crayons, whatever way you have that you like to color. But the colors that I am using here, I've got Old Olive, I've got Pumpkin Pie, Highland Heather, Daffodil Delight, Crumb Cake, Flirty Flamingo, and Smoky Slate. So if you want to make yours exactly like mine, those are the colors that I have. All right, so let's just start with treat number one. Now, I have also emailed PDF instructions, so I like to do both kinds of instructions for my people, just depending on what is easier for them. They can follow whichever way they would like to. But for this one, you're going to need that big piece of orange polka dot paper that was just included in the kit. This is 6x8. And then these Reese's pieces. I chose these, obviously they're orange, which is awesome for Halloween, but I got them from Walgreens. They had them on sale for $1, where normally these movie kind of treats are a little bit more than that. So they were $1 during the month of September, so that's why I did these. And I'm just going to wrap this paper all the way around this box of treats, but first I'm going to do a bow around here. And I just put the bow around the paper only because at that point you could slide the cute wrapper on and off and eat your treat without ruining it. And so I know a lot of people like that. And so that's the way I did it this way. So I know I want my bow to be off to the side, and I'm going to get my ribbon lined up so that I have about the same length on both ends here. I'll just start by tying a knot, just a regular basic knot, and I'm going to hold it with one finger. And whichever end is going downward, that's the one that you're going to do your knot, your loop. Now with the other one, wrap around the back, and then you just tuck right into that space. Make sure you're still kind of holding this tight while you tighten the bow. And then you can just play with this, make it a little tighter or whatever. And so funny, I did all that work, but then it's actually the right side where we want this. Okay, so right about like that, and then we'll go ahead and fold this around So what I'm going to do is use my Seal Plus adhesive. This is my paper to paper adhesive usually, but anytime I'm doing like a box or anything kind of complicated, I use this adhesive for that as well. So get that glued down here. We're gonna bring it across and do some creasing, get it creased here and here. Ooh, I'm hearing a lot of background clatter. Hopefully that's not bothering you guys. I've got my 17-year-old son doing the dishes outside the room. So that's a good thing. Gotta give Jack a little round of applause for doing his chores. Okay, so we're gonna put in a little bit more Seal Plus right there. And then when I bring this around, I'm gonna try to get it to line up. Obviously it doesn't matter if it's like completely perfect or not. There we go. But now, see, we'll be able to open this and eat the treats without messing up the packaging. Won't that be good? So we've got our box. Let's come over here to some of these little pieces. This will be our first stamping. Going to get this cute little ghost. I've been watching the Harry Potter movies lately. So to me, this little guy looks like a Quidditch player on his broom. Cute. Let's get that stamped. On this little gray piece, this has been cut with the countryside corners. I'm going to ink up the bat and just kind of get a few of these. Something like that. About three of those. Also do Happy Halloween. I want it off-center, kind of on the right side, and we'll just put it up a little bit. Something like that. Okay, now let's do a little bit of coloring here. Oh, it looks like I smeared that a little. I bet you can't see that on the video though, and I'm going to cut it off. So we're just gonna pretend that never happened. And I'm going to color his cute little cape with my pumpkin pie. I'm using the light pumpkin pie. Coloring the patch orange as well. Let's go back over a couple spots on this cape, just darken it a little. I did not do a lot of special blending on any of these projects, but you could if you wanna get real fancy. I've used the dark Daffodil Delight to do this little buckle on the front of the hat and also the bristles on the broom. Let's go to our crumb cake. This is a very skinny little broomstick, so I'm using my bullet tip, little pink tongue. Okay, and then we'll do the hat with the dark smoky slate. Just doing stripes. I started with the brim, colored that the dark, and then I'll just do every other stripe. Okay, now I'm just going to grab my paper snips and cut this out around here. This, a lot of people call it fussy cutting because it's a little fussy. I'm cutting carefully around something. But a few tips to make it easier, you're going to leave a white edge. See how I've left a little white gap around the design? Makes it very forgiving, so it'll look good even though your cutting won't be perfect. Another tip, make sure you're using Stampin Up paper snips. They are extremely sharp, designed to cut paper like this. Another tip, use your non-cutting hand to do the moving of the paper. See how my left hand is rotating the paper and doing all the moving? My scissor hand is staying very steady. And I pretty much keep the paper that I'm cutting kind of in the center of the scissor blade. So I don't usually use the tip to do any cutting, and I don't cut open it all the way to do any cutting because I don't have as much control that way. So I'll just put it about in the middle, and then I will cut for a few moments until I'm not having good control, and then I'll open the scissors again. The last tip I would say is just not to get too freaked out about it. This is also something I don't do very often, but this little guy kind of called for it. You're gonna see in a minute why this project is so much better with the ghost cut out. Also, it worked out well since I smeared the ink here on by his tail. I can just cut that right off. And any kind of divot that goes way in like this, I'm not gonna go in super far. I'll just go in a bit and come back out. We don't need to cut that space. Okay, let's bring this together now. I've cut out a cloud for you. This is from Glimmer Paper. And so it's so cute. It's from the Bright Skies dies. And I'm so happy we had white glimmer paper to do this because it turned out so good. I'm using glue dots. The back of these glimmer papers is kind of like glossy. And so I didn't want to deal with trying to roll Seal Plus on there. Okay, so I'm gonna put the cloud about here so it's between my two bats. And then this little guy, I'm going to use the mini Stampin' Dimensionals, just these little baby ones, so that I can go up in these spaces. If you don't have these guys, you can cut some down or you can keep your dimensionals focused more to the middle of the image too. Everything's allowed. All right, now let's bring this adorable ghost. He's going to like overlap right up onto the cloud just a little. I'm not gonna have the broom go off of the tag very much, and he'll just kind of be up here like that. And then this tag will go on to the front of our box. So we can adjust this ribbon how we want it. I did put this on dimensionals. So let's grab those. Looks like I'm kind of down to my sides, but no worries because I like to use the edges too. Just kind of pull off chunks of them. I'm looking at the whole box. I want the label to be kind of in the middle-ish. Okay, and this is treat number one. Are you so excited to give that to someone for Halloween? Okay, time for treat number two. This one is just a few little pieces in a bag here. Go ahead and dump these out. There's a little ribbon too. And this one goes with the black and white lollipop. So these lollipops I found on Amazon. And they were 24 in a box for, I don't know, maybe $15 or $12, something like that. So somewhere around like 50 cents a piece. And I'm just going to take the side of my Stampin' Lens marker, tilt it all the way to the side, and brush color onto this bit of ribbon. So I'm turning the ribbon purple. This is my Dark Highland Heather. You can flip it over, see if those edges need any more. Usually bleeds through pretty well. Okay, let's set this aside to dry while we're working on the rest of it. You've got a little scrap of cardstock. Any scrap will do. We're just gonna stamp Trick or Treat on there. And then right here, I've got a cute little label. This is cut from the Unbounded Love dies, I think. And the little vampire ghost fits pretty well. This little vampire ghost, he gets me. He is very cute. Okay, I'm going to use the light Highland Heather to color his cape. I had a little extra color around the folds here and on the inside layer. I thought it might be darker there. And just do a little bit of that kind of thing if you want to. And I'm using the light smoky slate to color his kind of little vampire head here. The stamp set is all ghosts. The ghosts are dressing up as different things. So our first one was a witch ghost. This one's a little vampire ghost. And the inside of his ear, just a little bit of pink. And I think that's good. Now these dies are super fun because in the set there was also this frame piece, and look how it perfectly frames this little die. He looks like a little portrait that would be in the hallway of Dracula's castle. I love it. We are going to use a bit of our Tombow multi-liquid glue. So let me cut this out first. We're just gonna cut like a tight little squarish around here. And that leaves us with some scraps, and I'll use one of these scraps to put a bit of glue on. A lot of times if I'm putting glue on something real small, I'll put the glue on my scrap paper first like that. Now I can just barely touch these edges in a few places and just get a little bit of glue on here. We'll kind of spread that out. We don't want any big gobs anywhere. And then just lay that right on top of the little dotted edge. It should fit exactly. I would love to do a whole series of portraits with this. Do all different glimmer paper frames. Wouldn't that be so fun? Or maybe a gold frame. Love how that turned out. Okay, let's check out our ribbon, see how that's doing. Come over here and tie. I'm just going to tie a knot. Just tucking this under. I want it way up high, right on the sucker. Trim these ends. They look good. I'm using a couple of dimensionals to attach this. I played with a lot of ways to decorate these suckers, but I really liked this way in particular because the sucker still showed a little bit. And you could see it's just a really cute sucker, so I didn't want to totally hide it. And we'll put just one little baby dimensional right on the trick-or-treat. We're gonna place that right here. Kind of cover up some of his cape. Lined it up with the edge of the frame just about on that left side. And that is project number two. Okay, this one is treat number three. And this one had the treat packed right inside the bag here. A little bit of cinnamon apple herbal tea. I got these from Walmart. Just a couple dollars for a pack of 20. So really, really inexpensive. The designer paper that I've been using for these is from a set called Halloween Spells that is currently in the online exclusives with Stampin' Up. So you can check that out. Let's go ahead and start with some of the stamping. So this deckled edge circle is going to have our little ghost with a jack-o'-lantern, and he just kind of barely fits. So I'm gonna make sure the pumpkin's on at the bottom and press it down. Perfect. This little banner, we want the V to be on the left side, and then we will ink up Boo and just stamp that right in the space here. And then this little piece, we're going to create a little card, and this piece is going to go on the inside. So there's this fun little spooky cloud. And let's stamp that kind of in the middle up high, and then go up and to the left without re-inking. So we got kind of a darker and a lighter cloud there. And then we'll go back to our bats. One kind of here, and one kind of here. Okay, so that's a little, goes inside of the little card that we're going to make. So let's go to this piece. I've got it scored for you. I'm trying to remember what the size was here. This is 5 1/4 by 6, okay? And so the 6 direction, it is scored right down the middle, so it folds in half. 5 1/4 direction, it is scored just up a little bit so that you can get this cute little pocket. Okay, so I'm gonna fold this up first, and then I'll fold this closed, and that is how we want the whole thing to be folded. I don't see my bone folder right here, but that would probably be the best way to get it done. And then we're going to tie this ribbon all the way around. So let's get it measured so we've got equal tails on both sides. Put it right here, coming through the middle. Let's put a couple of mini glue dots here. Okay, so that'll help hold that right where we want it. And then we can come over here. On the inside, we're going to glue our little place to write a note right over the pocket and everything on the left side. So let's put a little seal plus all four sides here. This will have a little frame around it, so just kind of bump it in on all the edges. And now the little tea packet is gonna go right here. The blue kind of didn't match, and that's why I've cut out this little peach pie banner and we put a boo on it. We're gonna just cover up the great value. Boo. So now when your recipient pulls it out, it just says cinnamon apple herbal tea, just like that. You can go ahead and tie this shut now. Okay, now let's work on our cute little card front. That's going to be this piece right here. We're gonna use some pumpkin pie for the pumpkin. I'm going to go over the whole thing with the light pumpkin pie first. Coloring his little pumpkin lid here as well. This is the light pumpkin pie, so I'm doing the edge too. Whole hat. Let's do these little edges on the eyes. Okay, let's jump now to the dark pumpkin pie and just give it some depth. So I'm going around the carving, going down the lines, going along the edge up here. Okay, and then we'll just go one more time with the light color and blend the whole thing up. So you can pull the dark and the light back together. I'll use my light Daffodil Delight to give this pumpkin a little bit of a glow. Give him a little green stem up here. And he's smiling so big, you see that cute little tongue. So I'm putting a little flirty flamingo there. And now I'm gonna do something kind of fun with this one. I'm using my light Daffodil Delight. Let's make sure we've got the brush tip. I'm going to go all the way around my image with this color. And you can just leave the shadow or you can fill it in. Okay, so there's just with a little shadow, and here's how I did mine. I went ahead and filled it in all the way to the edge. I just love how the contrast of the white ghost pops. Few dimensionals on the back of this guy, and he is ready to get attached to the little card front. I'm carefully peeling him off because I forgot something. Okay, if the dimensionals stayed, that's great. We'll be able to use those. I had little bats on here too, so let's add some. You could do with or without this, but I like this little bat image. I think it's very cute, kind of spooky. Okay, now we're ready. Let's go back to these dimensionals. Ta-da! We'll untie it. Boo! Okay, time for our fourth and last treat. Let's pull the pieces out of kit number four. A lot of love goes into the prep for these. I always die cut everything for you. Prepare every little piece. And this one is going to have ghost dots. How cute are these? I was so psyched when I found a box of these. And perfect for our ghost stamp set that we were using. But then it was so tiny. The image that I decided to use on this one is just the little pumpkin. So let's pull in our memento pad. We hadn't used this cute little guy yet. There we go. Okay, so for the strip of glimmer paper, I have just cut a piece. It is 6.5 by 1, and we're gonna let it be whole on the back. And so we'll just kind of lay it across the back, fold, 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 fold. Bring all these ends up. And we're going to use Stampin' Dimensionals to hold it. Just have this funky little corner left, so. On here, but see how it's holding the paper in place, but then it's also peeled and ready to stick my layers to it as well. So let's come over to our pumpkin. We're going to color this in a pretty similar way. I'm starting by filling the whole thing, both pumpkins, in with the light pumpkin pie. Using a little bit of light green on this leaf. Back to my crumb cake for these little stems. Then we can come in with a little bit of detail. I'm using my bullet tip on the darker pumpkin pie. Just kind of give it some darker dimension here. If you want to, you can blend the whole thing with the light again. And then I'm going to use this little leaf. This is from the same die set that those cute little frames were in. I think it's Unbounded Love. I hope that's right. Okay, I went and checked it. That was right, Unbounded Love. And we're just gonna take this cute little leaf and let it poke out from under the pumpkin. So I had some Seal Plus there so that that could glue to it. And now I have just one little piece of dimensional left, so I might as well put that one on. And let's place that right here. And there's our little ghost dots. Here's everything from our Halloween Treats class. So glad you guys signed up to join in and get this class from me. If you aren't a part of my card club and didn't get it, sign up for next time. Look in the link in my description. I do this card club every month. I usually have an optional add-on class, and this is what it was this time. Everybody has the Playful Ghost set to keep, which is so fun, and then these fun four projects to give away or copy or do whatever you want with them. Hope you guys had fun today. Thanks for watching. Bye!